Church. Our service of Holy Eucharist begins on page 355 in the Book of Common Prayer and page 2 of your leaflet. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. You know our necessities before we ask and our ignorance in asking. Have compassion on our weakness and mercifully give us those things for which our unworthiness we dare not, for our blindness we cannot ask. Through the worthiness of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the reading.
Today's first reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapters 44, verses 6 through 8. Thus says the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first, and I am the last. Besides me there is no God. Who is like me? Let them proclaim it, let them declare and set it before me. Who has announced from old the things to come? Let them tell us what is yet to be. Do not fear or be afraid. Have I not told you from of old and declared it? You are my witnesses. And is there any God besides me? There is no other rock. I know not one. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm for today is Psalm 86, verses 11 through 17. Let us read in unison. Teach me your way, O Lord, and I will walk in your truth. Knit my heart to you, that I may fear your name. I will thank you, O Lord my God, with all my heart, and glorify your name forevermore. For great is your love toward me. You have delivered me from the nethermost pit. The arrogant rise up against me, O God, and then the violent men seek my life. They have not set you before their eyes. But you, O Lord, are gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and full of kindness and truth. Turn to me and have mercy upon me. Give your strength to your servant and save the child of your handmaid. Show me a sign of your favor, so that those who hate me may see it and be ashamed. because you, O Lord, have helped me and comforted me.
The second reading is from Paul's letter to the church in Rome. So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now, and not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's stand and sing together the sequence hymn, Savior, Like a Shepherd, Lead Us.
Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Another parable Jesus put to the crowds. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seeds in his field. But while everyone was asleep, the enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore again, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seed in the field? Where then did these weeds come from? He answered, An enemy has done this. The slave said to him, Then do you want us to go and gather them? But he replied, No, for in gathering the weeds you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest. And at the harvest time, I will tell the reapers, Collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn. Then he left the crowds and went into the house. And the disciples approached him again, saying, Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field. He answered, The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seeds are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Good morning.
Good morning.
I think I'm moving this just a hair. Before I start today, I just want to kind of put out the little request out there that you take care of your neighbors these next couple days as we go through all this heat. Make sure you check in on somebody and give them a call, and also take care of yourselves. I think it's very important. I think it's going to be probably the hottest we're going to be for a little while, so please take care. I don't have any papers in front of me today. I have a little note here, kind of for important things so I don't forget. So my sermon could be either very short, could be in between, or it could be very long. But we'll try to keep it as the regular time. How's that? As in all Gospels are meant for us to look at, and in some ways change how we think, change how we see things, change the way we live, and I guess you could say more or less change things sometimes in our heart, how we feel and how we look towards others and how we look at our own lives. And this gospel is no different. In fact, this gospel is quite pointed, if anything. And if you read it here, just to kind of clarify a little bit, when they talk about the wheat and the weeds, back in that day there was a weed that was called darnel or false wheat. And you couldn't tell the difference when it was young or was very difficult. Maybe the trained eye could, but for most people they couldn't until it started to mature. So all the wheat and the weeds as they were growing looked the same. There's no difference. When they became noticeable, then the slaves went to the owner and said, "Should we pull them out?" And he says, "No, because by that time now the roots have all wrapped together. So if you pull out the bad, you're going to pull out the good at the same time." So he would say, what does that have to do with us today? Well, I will say this. If there's good and bad there in the field where there's wheat and there's weeds, if we were to walk down the street and let's say we would pass 10 people, would you be able to tell who was good and who was bad? Would you be able to tell that in a very short time, or maybe in a long time, in 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, that an addict would turn his life around? Would you know that if you saw an alcoholic, would you know when maybe the next month something would happen that would change him? Would you then, when you look at them, say, "This one is bad. This one is bad, this one is good, this one is bad"? I can't tell. I can't tell when I go down the street who's good and who's bad. Because number one, I don't look at their color. Number one, I don't care really whether they're good or bad. I want to see them with the eyes of love. I want to see them as they treat me, I will treat them. And even if they treat me bad, I'll continue to try to treat them good. So they'll see something in me that maybe perhaps they didn't see before. And in Jesus' eyes, he's telling us it's not your business to decide who's good and who's bad. You have no right to decide who's good and who's bad. But you do have the right and the responsibility to continually walk in faith, walk in love, no matter who you meet, no matter what circumstances happen. That is your responsibility. And as we grow in faith, others will see that. And in fact, when it says in here that, you know, there's good and there's bad and there's sin, if you'd say that person is sinful, you would say, whoops, wait a minute. I thought I read someplace that we are all born in sin and all fall short of the glory.
No.
So now who's the sinner? We all are. So how do you judge? We don't. And Jesus doesn't want us to judge. And that's the gist that's in this parable. If you read on the latter part of that, and it says, he explains what he means by the parable of the weeds. The one who sows the seed, of course, is the Son of Man. The field is the world, as it is today. The good seed are the children of the kingdom, and the weeds are the children of the evil one. And the enemy who sowed them is the devil, and the harvest is the end of age, and the reapers are the angels. And then it kind of gets a little scary, and it says, just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels and collect them out in his kingdom and all causes of sin and evildoers, and they will throw them into a furnace of fire where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father, and let anyone with ears listen. Now, do you think Jesus meant this parable to be taken literally? I don't. He doesn't mean this literally, but he means it seriously. Everything he's saying here, he means seriously, to take it seriously in your heart, to listen, to be in the world. I myself am so grateful and so thankful that my grandparents didn't throw me out, didn't pluck me out of all the good, that my wife didn't pluck me out, that my children didn't throw me out, that the church didn't throw me out, that they kept me. Because I am an example of those who someone would have judged me 10 years ago, well, I should say 11 years ago, time flies, 11 years ago, they could have said, you belong out, you don't belong with us. But they didn't. And somehow, some way, through the love of Christ, I came around, and I'm here today. So again, that's one of the reasons that I say we have no right and no business to judge anybody, but to just show love, because you don't know. You don't know that time will come when somebody will look at you as you're walking down the street and you just see something in their face that brings warmth in your own heart. So it should remind you then that I should walk down the street the same way, with nothing but the light of Christ, nothing but warmth in my heart, non-judgmental. And in today's world, it's not easy. There's no doubt about that. We're bombarded every single minute by the media, by politicians and everyone else who want to harvest all the evil and the bad things that are going on. And it's hard. But Jesus didn't promise us that it was going to be easy. He didn't tell us that as long as you believe in me, everything's going to be rosy. Your bank account will be fine. The world will be fine. Nothing's ever going to happen to you. No one will die. You'll never get sick.
Amen.
Jesus didn't promise that. He just promised that if we continue in his love, in the light of him, that we'll have everlasting life. And there is a different kind of happiness. I remember some times before when I was happy for not very good reasons. But now I'm happy for all the right reasons. And more happy today, I don't know if that's a correct term or not, more happy, but I'm happier today than I've ever been. And I sleep very well. Yes, there's trouble in the world. There's no doubt about it. But how we look at it, how we go about it, that's the big difference. If we go about it condemning, we're going to be condemned. If we go about it trying our very best to try to understand what this gospel and other gospels are about, how this gospel could possibly change our lives, change how we see people, change how we see this world, even change how we see some of our politicians, as hard as that can be, things will be good. It won't always be the rosy thing that we're used to, but it'll be better. So if you read this gospel and you think about the wheat and the weeds, when you walk down the street, think about WW. What am I looking at? Am I trying to determine the weeds, or am I trying to determine the wheat? It's not your job. Your job is to look at them with love. Look at them with kindness. Look at them the same way you want to be treated. And also look maybe beyond that and say, I know, maybe this person someday I'll meet in a different place, different circumstance, okay? And I'll know who they are. And I'll judge it. I won't judge them, and I won't judge anybody. And least of all, not to judge yourselves. Amen.
Amen.
Standing, and turning in your bulletin to page 6, or page 358 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us reaffirm our faith through the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people are found on page 6. In peace we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work,
for our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone, for this community, the nation, and the world,
for all who work for justice, freedom, and peace, for the just and proper use of your creation,
for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression, for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble,
for those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy, for the peace and unity of the Church of God,
for all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth, for Michael, our presiding bishop, for Daniel, our bishop, for myself, your rector, and for Lou, our deacon, for all bishops and other ministers,
for all who serve God and his church, for the special needs and concerns of this congregation.
This time I invite you to give your intercessions either silently or aloud for those that you need, for those on the St. James prayer list. Hear us, Lord,
for your mercy is great. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life.
Heavenly Father, I give thanks, Lord, for this community. I give thanks, Lord, for all those who are working to find a vaccine for COVID-19. Just give thanks, Lord, for all those who live their lives thinking of others, for those who wear their mask in public, and for those who are worried and dedicated to keeping others safe. We'll exalt you, O God, our King,
and praise your name forever and ever. We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom.
For the saints of St. James, for my mother. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them
who put their trust in you. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins.
Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, who may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins to our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Share God's peace. Peace. Peace.
Peace.
Peace,
everybody.
Peace. All right. You all may be seated. Announcements. As Lou said, please stay cool. It's really, really warm outside. Make sure you stay hydrated. Take good care of yourself. Lauren, do you have any announcements? Carol, what do we need at the outreach house?
Everything.
Everything.
Baby wipes and diapers and training pants.
Baby wipes, diapers, and training pants. We need those. And I just give thanks for all the volunteers and all the things that's been coming in for the outreach house. Lou?
Don't forget Copland on Wednesday, 8 o'clock. Be there. So hopefully soon I'll be able to do traveling Copland. We're working on that now, so hopefully I can get the bugs out. So
right.
We'll work on it.
Church, 3 weeks ago, I preached a sermon in which I had stated that 50 police officers have been shot in the head since the beginning of the year. It was an erroneous website. I should have checked it closer than I did. There's no doubt that there's been violence against police, and my point in my sermon was that violence is not a Christian virtue, but truth-telling is. So I wanted to say to you that I used an erroneous website in my sermon. I still believe that violence in any form is not a Christian virtue. Truth-telling is, and so is forgiveness. So I'm asking you all to forgive me for not vetting a website more than I should have. And I appreciate all of you who have already talked to me about it and called me and told me how much they appreciated my sermon. But I just wanted to make sure that you all know I'm sorry, and I will try my best to vet these things. Birthdays. I know that it is Adele Ray's birthday. I know that. Janice, is it your birthday?
My birthday on Wednesday.
Her birthday on Wednesday. So we've got Janice and we've got Adele for birthdays. Adele turns 93 this week. Yay! 93. So all of you who are here, stand. If you're at home, grab your prayer book. Turn to page 830 in your prayer books. Prayer number 50, as we pray for Janice and Adele on their birthdays. Let us pray. O God, our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants, Janice and Adele, as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace, and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Are you ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Janice and Adele. Happy birthday to you. Oh boy, that sounded good. Thank you. Any other things to be thankful for? I'm thankful for the generosity of this church. I'm thankful for all those who are here. As you all have seen, that the governor's put out more restrictions. We're worried about spikes in COVID-19. I think we're making the right decision by being slow here. Please know, after service today, 11:30 to 12:30, we will be here for you all to receive communion. All right? I don't know what I picked today.
That's right.
Ascribe, ascribe unto the Lord the honor to his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts with praise. Service of Holy Eucharist continues with the Great Thanksgiving. Eucharistic Prayer B, found on page 367 in the Book of Common Prayer and page 8 in your bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and a joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For you are the source of light and life. You made us in your own image and called us into a new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Glory, 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 glory,
We give thanks to O God for the goodness and love which you made known to us in creation, and the calling of Israel to be your people, and your word spoken through the prophets, and above all the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil, and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, the Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to him, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, and they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. And in the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. James, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen."
Christ died for you, and being in him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Heavenly Father, we ask your blessings upon this, your servant today. Amen. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Your leaflet on page 11 or page 365 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us stand and pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food and the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the Book of Common Prayer it states, if a person desires to receive the sacrament, but by reason of extreme sickness or physical disability is unable to eat and drink the bread and wine, the celebrant is to assure that person that all benefits of communion are received, even though the sacrament is not received with the mouth. During this time of the pandemic, we're unable to gather. The restriction creates a physical disability, causing us to be separated. Despite our separations, we are assured of the benefits of God's grace given to us at the Eucharist. Please pray this prayer with me. My Jesus, I know that you are present in the Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. May you love graciously, forgive unconditionally, and practice radical hospitality. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen. right, church, are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Alleluia, alleluia.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. God bless. See you all in an hour.